Johar, hello everyone. I am Archana Soreng from Kharia Tribal Community. I'm from Sundargarh district of Odisha and I'm currently working as research officer in Vasundhara, Odisha, an action research and policy advocacy organization working on natural resource governance, tribal rights and climate justice. I have been recently selected as one of the 7 members of United Nations Secretary General's Youth Advisory Group on Climate Change. I thank you all for giving me this opportunity to share my insights and field experiences with you all. So Ash shared with me that I have to speak about how to reinforce Article 12 of Paris Agreement to create awareness, promote education and participation among public. I would first of all would like to say, when we talk about creating awareness and promoting education, I strongly feel it is important to be aware first. We ourselves need to be aware first. And same goes when we talk about promoting education. It is important for us to be educated. When I say educated, it is not only about the school education which I am talking about, but to educate ourselves by interacting with the community members, by interacting with the people, those who are affected by climate crisis, by interacting with the people, those who are in the frontliners of climate action. So now I'll be talking about how do we create awareness, how do we aware ourselves. So I would like to share my experiences. So I have been working on documentation, research and understanding the traditional knowledge and practices of the indigenous communities here in Odisha and India. So when I look back in my journey, in 2015, when I was elected as national convener of Tribal Commission, we had organized summer camps wherein we had gone to the community members, stayed with them for 24 hours. We were divided in groups and wherein we were sent to various different villages. Now, this 24 hours of my life is something which I cherish till now, because that is when I realized that how the community members are leading an eco-friendly life and how they are protecting nature. It's very important for ourselves to interact with the community members, those who are protecting, and to interact with the community members, those who are in the front line of protection of nature and forest. And once you are educated, once you are aware about those practices, it will help you to understand that how they have been contributing along with what you are studying in your books. So that is how that 24 hours helped me in realizing that or reinforcing the things which I had seen from my childhood. So what I want to say is that it is very important to interact with the community members, those who are affected by climate crisis and those who are frontliners in the climate action. Now, I would suggest, like, is it possible that once in a month or once in a 3 month or once in a year, we make it an effort to go and interact with them, to go and interact with the people, those who are affected by climate crisis like floods, droughts, cyclone, so that we know the intensity, that how people are affected and why it is so important to speak up on that. And then when I pursued my master's in Tata Institute of Social Sciences, where I did master's in regulatory governance, then I realized that climate crisis or climate action has to be taken very seriously and has to be spoken about now. Now the challenge remains or the concern remains, how do we do about it? How do we promote education? Then I realized it is very important to write. It is very important to document. And then I realized to create awareness and promote education, it is important to write and document. And when I say about document or sharing of knowledge, it is can be in any form. You can sing, you can dance, you can write, you can draw. We as a youth can use various mediums to share awareness, and that is how will enable us to create more and more participation. Because as we all know, many people do not get the opportunity of getting education. But how do we share this information? Maybe painting, drawing can help people, those who are not able to read and write. Maybe singing song, dancing and different cultural expression will help people to understand these issues. So I feel it is very important to use different modes of communication, different modes of documentation to engage and to reinforce the Article 12 of Paris Agreement. Now I want to also say, when we talk about promoting education and participation and awareness, it is also not only creating awareness to others, it is important to create awareness among our family member. It is important to create awareness within ourselves. I strongly feel conservation of nature is very personal. It is only when you realize that you want to make a change, that you want to act for climate action, and not only by speaking but by your action, that is when you in a real sense will be able to participate in this process. And I strongly feel that we all youth have to realize that we want a good life. We want a life with the family members. We want a life with the loved ones. We want to have good career and jobs. But only when we are alive, we will able to have those. And for to live alive, currently the threat is climate crisis. Only when we act for climate action, that is how we'll be able to stay alive. And having said this, I strongly feel that we youth have to come together collectively. I know everyone is doing individually and collectively in their own spaces, but we have to bring it together. Like for example, I am here from Odisha. I feel we youth specifically need to see around ourselves, see that is it possible to make a sharing circle in my colony? Is it possible to make a sharing circle in my residence? Wherein, you know, we are students of different schools and come together and decide what will we do for our own residential area. It is very important to make an effort to go and talk to the elders of your residence. How is the waste management being done? How is the electricity management is being done? How is the sanitation being done? What can we do? We have to go and ask them and show them the interest that we are interested to keep our residence, our area of living clean and green. We as a community want to act for climate action. Along with that, I also feel we have to be mindful of the way of living which we are having. I would like to share one of my field experiences. So when I had gone for my field experiences, in Sundargarh district. I had gone to the Pauri Bhuiya tribal communities, wherein for my field visit, the community leader, when I interacted with him, he told me that we'll be going to the another village. So I said, yes, I'm willing to go to the another village. Then we started walking. After some time, I was very tired. I was like, when will we reach? Then he said, we'll have to cross a forest, river, mountain, and then we will reach another village. We kept on walking amongst the forest. A bit tired I was, but the community leader was very enthusiastic and he kept walking. Then I realized, after walking, when we finally reached the place, it was 5 kilometers that we walked. And again from that way, we kept walking and 5 kilometers back to the place from where we had started. So ultimately, it was 10 kilometers that we walked to and fro. And by the time we came back, I was all exhausted. But the community leader was very strong and firm. And that is when I realized how much these communities, indigenous communities, Adivasi and forest dwelling communities, are combating climate crisis. Their way of living is so eco-friendly because there was no carbon emission in this entire 10 kilometers journey. But we need to reflect, we people in the cities, even for half a kilometer or 1 kilometer, we are using vehicles, and which is leading to carbon emission. So when we talk about participation, awareness and promotion, it is also to reflect on our action. How, along with speaking or raising voice, do we make changes in our own action? Maybe we can make a choice that we can start cycling where is it possible for the nearer distances. Maybe we can take up walking for the nearer distances. Let us be mindful of our way of living and make small efforts what we can do. Maybe when we go to the markets, when we see there are alternative to plastics, like I said, leaf plate or bags or chairs and tables or mat made by the indigenous communities, Adivasi and forest dwelling communities, which they have made out of the leaf, out of the plant, strings, roots. Can we say yes to those communities and purchase from them and no to plastic? If you purchase from them, not only you are adopting an eco-friendly life, but you are also encouraging those communities to continue with those practices and also giving them some source of income which will enable their livelihood. And that is how we have to help each other and support each other as a community. And lastly, yes, innovation. Let us try innovating new things, new techniques, and let us push forward how we can bring alternatives and how we can engage in climate action. It is only when I feel I want to contribute, I am willing to contribute, and I have to contribute, then we'll be able to create awareness, promote education and participation amongst public. And specifically, when I say about public, let us start from our own family, own neighbors, own community, own state, country, and entire globe. Thank you so much.